Hello my beautiful dolls, welcome back to my channel. Today's tutorial is about the makeup look I wore on my birthday last week. Most of the products I have used in this tutorial are new to me, so if you want to know how I got this look, then please keep on watching. Now starting with the eyes, I'm using my fingers to blend the Milani eye primer on my eyes. Next, I'm gonna take some LA Loose powder to set that eye base so that the colors get blended really easily. Using this frosted kind of a white color from the Faces Stackable Eyeshadows, I am using it as a brow bone highlight on both of my eyes, and I love the pigmentation of this color. Next, I am gonna use this charcoal gray kind of a color from the same stack above the crease and blend it really well. I'm not gonna go in the crease with this shade, I just need it as a transition shade on my eyes, so I'm putting it above my crease. Now I'm taking the clean blending brush to blend both of the shades together so that it gives a really radiant effect and looks really seamless. Now to deepen up the eyes a little bit, I am gonna take this black color and put this in the outer V of the eyes and till the crease and blend it well with the above gray shade that we used earlier above the crease. Now this is the only color that disappointed me in this stack of eyeshadows. It had a lot of fallout with a little pigmentation and I didn't really enjoy working with this color. Using the same white color that we used as the brow bone highlight, I'm putting it in the inner corner of the eyes to really open up my eyes. And this is actually the most beautiful color that I love from the Stackable eyeshadows. I loved working with this shade. I have used it as my highlight in the later stages as well. You'll see in a bit. Taking this silvery gray shade from the stack, I'm packing this on my eyelids till the crease and making sure all the colors are looking as similar as possible on both the eyes. Putting some more black shadow in the crease and blending it well with the silver gray shade so that everything looks really seamless. Now going in with some coats of mascara, as I'm gonna go with eyelashes later on. I did mess up with the lashes this time because I poked my right eye with the lashes, so you can tell that that it didn't go well on my eye, so I apologize for that. Now using a black pencil, I lined my lower as well as my upper waterline. Moving on to my face, I'm using some of the makeup wipes to clean any fallout that the eyeshadows may have done on my face. And I'm using the moisturizer before applying any kind of a base on my skin to hydrate it well. I did forget to put on any primer because I was in a rush, but I was out for only 2 or 3 hours, so my makeup lasted pretty well. So do put on a primer before putting on any foundation. I made a mistake, you don't have to. To cancel out any pigmentation on my face, I did go in with a peach corrector on the acne scars as well as around my mouth to cancel out any darkness around my lips, and I am blending it well with the beauty blender. For the foundation, I used my Colourbar foundation stick in the shade Natural. Now it is a shade lighter than my skin tone, so I did mix it with a darker foundation later on. I applied this generously under the eyes as a concealer. It is not a perfect foundation for me, but it really works well as a concealer for me. Using the damp Real Techniques sponge, I am spreading it evenly on my face. As you can already tell, this is not my perfect match. One of the drawbacks of online shopping, you cannot be perfectly sure of the shades you order. So I did mix it with my darker shade foundation that I own, the Milani foundation, to balance everything out. Don't be afraid of mixing two foundations. It will not make you look cakey at all or anything. Mixing foundations is a perfect way to get your perfect shade. If applied properly, it won't look cakey on your face. Use the same color bar foundation stick as a concealer under the eyes, on the nose, on the forehead, cupid's bow, as well as on the chin, and we'll be blending it out with the Real Techniques sponge. I did hate this shade as my foundation, but I love this as my concealer. Again, for bronzing up my skin, I am going completely out of my comfort zone and trying out a new technique and a new product. I used the Body Shop All-in-One Concealer by picking two shades darker than my skin tone, and I'm using this orangey brown shade of this concealer. So basically, this is a concealer darker than my shade, which I am using as a liquid bronzer on my face, on the usual areas that I like to bronze up my skin. I did not like it in the beginning when I'm putting it on my face, but when I blended it out, it really worked well as a bronzer, and it gave a really sun-kissed effect to my face. Blending it all well with my Real Techniques sponge. And I did film a video regarding my base makeup routine, so if you're interested in that, the link will be mentioned in the description box below. Once all the colors are blended well, I am gonna move on to the powders. Using LA Pro Loose Powder to set all the areas that I concealed and highlighted. Using the Bahama Mama bronzer to darken up the contour areas a little bit. Applying this mahogany shade of the Deborah blush on the apples of my cheeks, and for the highlighter I used the same stackable eyeshadows and used the silvery white shade that I used under my eyebrows on the brow bone, and as well as in the inner corner of the eyes, and I'm using it as a highlighter on my cheekbones, on my nose a little bit, and on the cupid's bow as well. Moving on to the eyes, I'll be smoking out my lower lash line with this silvery grey shade that we applied on our eyelids, and smoking it out, and I really like the smoked effect on my eyes. Once I'm done with that, I added some coats of mascara on the lower lashes as well. And for the lips, I used the Faces Ultimate Pro Long Wear Matte Lipstick in the shade Flirty Pink. I did not like it that much, so to cool it down a little bit, I then applied the NYX Matte Lipstick in the shade Nude. For the hair, I did a fringe braid a night before my birthday, and it is a perfect way to get heatless, wavy hair. And because I forgot to apply primer earlier, a setting spray is necessary to lock all the makeup in. So here I'm using the Slay All Day by Gerard Cosmetics so that my makeup does not budge all day. So here it is, you guys. This is how I did my makeup on my birthday. If you enjoy watching my tutorials, then don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel. We'll meet in my next video.